Is the entire India targeted as one country, or should people go even more granular in their approach in India?
No, I think India is not that complicated as it might seem from outside. I mean, they are different states, but at the end of the day, it's a united, you know, consortium of like United States, right? Like just like United States is a collection of all states, but central government has a uniform governance across the board. So, you know, it's not that complicated. There are several cultures, languages, you know, food that you might see, you know, unlike the Latin America. But that's the beauty of India. But you, even though you have so many people, the diversity that exists, the professional side of things is pretty uniform. So, you know, the way to pick up a market, I think I look at it from the problems and challenges we are facing as a blockchain community. The three challenges were regulatory, which we already talked about, but the other two are the development resource space, number one, and two is liquidity, untapped liquidity. Now let's talk just for a second, talk about the development resource space. India has 6,250 universities. They have 1.5 million engineers graduating every year. They have more than a million trained, experienced engineers with the existing technology services industry that comes to about $200 billion in services as an industry from India. They have the top four global technology service companies providers, which contribute today to about 8% of the entire 2.5 trillion GDP of the country. Now that's the resource pool that you can choose to ignore, but I don't think as a blockchain community we can afford to ignore, because a lot of the products that need to go mainstream, we have a whole bunch of cryptographers, scientists that are available on our teams, but what we really don't have is engineering pool to actually take them mainstream. And these companies, they service all the Fortune 500 companies today, or Fortune 1000 companies, building ERP level projects. So one is we should definitely look at India from a resource standpoint, from a technology resource standpoint. Now second, coming to the liquidity standpoint. Now, if you look at India, today India is about 2.6 trillion in GDP, which is close to UK. Everybody around India has this opportunity to tap the liquidity into the blockchain market, but India did not even touch the surface. Number one. Number two, if you look at just the family offices in India, they have about 7 trillion of net worth that is inside and outside the country. That has not been tapped. Number three, like I said, the Indian households are far more rich than what the numbers indicate, because numbers just indicate the physical income. It does not indicate the cash economy. It does not indicate the gold economy, which is parallel economies to what the GDP per capita in India today indicates. So there is a huge dearth of retail investors. If you look at the retail investor base, there are about 52.3 million people that are trading in the equity markets today in India, which is also a ginormous amount. And the retail investor base in India is not very different from China or Korea, for that matter. They are not the most educated retail investors who do all the research. It's very similar pain points. So fact of the matter is, if you have a pool of liquidity that is untapped so far from the crypto markets, you have a great resource pool of technology talent available. I mean, and it addresses, I think regulatory is something that will continue to evolve and is evolving. I don't know which country's government had 200 people from the government sent to a particular blockchain event to just understand what that is. So there is a pro action that is being taken by the Indian government. We are just doing a hackathon where we have signed up 2,000 developers, teams, over 3,500 developers, who are promoted by the government to participate. Like, where do you get such a support? Forget the crypto, like even in the blockchain industry, which government has actually supported this much? So I think from all these three perspectives and what is lacking in the blockchain community, we need to build powerhouses like we can build what we are trying to build in India. And I think I'm sure there are multiple markets like China, as they evolve, they'll come to be powerhouses. But if we don't create these powerhouses, we will continue to struggle to extend the blockchain community.